Senator Rick Scott was in Cape Coral today touring the damage Ian left behind at the Yacht Club and surrounding neighborhoods. A lot of people are still rebuilding there as well. NBC2's Jennifer Vaglis is at the Yacht Club showing us the damage the senator saw firsthand.
Well, today I spoke to neighbors living in single-story homes here near Dolphin Drive. They came back to their homes with a layer of muck on the ground. One woman I spoke to just moved back into her home after completely gutting it. Today she calls Senator Rick Scott's visit a pleasant surprise.
This is where we live. This is our home.
And for many, near the Cape Coral Yacht Club. It doesn't look anything like it did 4 months ago.
And everybody up and down the street was, was devastated.
Irene Giordano just moved back into her single-story home last week.
So out in the garage came up to 28 inches.
She stayed through Ian from inside her home, watching storm surge quickly rise.
I saw a kayak floating by.
So she grabbed her cat and hopped out her bedroom window.
It was pretty scary, yeah, because it was so windy. I mean, it was so loud and windy. And
paddling to her neighbor's two-story home, which she came back to later, a mucky mess. Tonight, grateful to see Senator Scott visiting.
Hopefully this will just be the start of something better where he can help us and things will improve, slowly but surely.
Senator Scott toured her community, seeing what residents need from the federal government.
How do we solve problems? You feel sorry for these families that when you tour that are still struggling.
This was a tough storm.
I mean, it feels hard for people.
Stopping by the Cape Coral Yacht Club.
I would definitely like to see that reopen as soon as possible. It is everything that is wonderful about Southwest Florida packed into a small area.
Now, next Thursday, city leaders will meet for an annual summit to discuss the future of the Cape Coral Yacht Club and whether it applies to the FEMA 50% rule. I'm live and local tonight in Southeast Cape Coral. Jennifer Vaglis, NBC2.